I have my retainer in. It's like a clear retainer. So that's what that is. I want to mention a couple of things about my last astral projection experience. Actually, two experiences. Yeah, so my last astral projection experience, and it's not the only astral projection experience where I've had this experience, where I've noticed this. I also noticed it in out-of-body experiences, lucid dreams. I think the lucid dreams that I experience are like the vast majority are out-of-body experiences. And I know that because when I did astral project and I was able to go outside and everything, I was able to experience what I experienced to be lucid dreams. Turns out they're out-of-body experiences. That's what I suspected. So out-of-body experiences and separating from the body. So there's one time where I was in the vibrational state and I ended up floating upward, like above my body, and then I ended up standing up at the foot of my bed. And so the vibrations, all the ringing, there's a ringing and vibrations that were going on. And then when I did this like energy work in the solar plexus, I ended up lifting, just floating out of my body. When the floating occurred, when I'm saying that I moved up to the foot of my bed, that wasn't my physical body. My physical body was still in bed and it was still there. My consciousness, so consciousness, right? The awareness that we have, the awake, that observer, the one that's experiencing and observing our consciousness, right? We like to think that it comes from our brain, but actually, science has not been able to show with brain scans and all sorts of things. Actually, consciousness cannot be identified in the body. It is connected to the body, but my consciousness, so my awareness, it was like I knew I wasn't in my physical body, but I still had this body that felt very similar, and my consciousness was attached to it, and I was able to move around and go. I even looked in the mirror. I ended up outside, and everything looked very similar, but there were differences. But I had zero feeling of my physical body. No feeling of my physical body. I wasn't. There are times where I'm in the separation process and I'm trying to separate, and I can feel my physical body and I can feel my astral body. My part of my limb, you know, my limbs will be disconnecting, and I go from feeling my physical limbs to feeling what feels like my physical limbs, but turns out they're not. Like it feels like I'm moving my arms and stuff, but I'm actually not. They're actually in the bed, and they're my astral arms, limbs that are moving. So consciousness leaves. And I don't feel my body that's in the bed. When I'm walking around, I go outside. It's like there's no feeling of that body in the bed. There's no, I know that it's breathing. I know that it's regulating itself. It's doing what it needs to do, but there's no actual perception of it. There's no feeling there because I'm separate from it. This last time, where I ended up floating and I felt what I think is the throat chakra, that one, I ended up. It was like this. It felt like a car that was revving. You know, like the revving of an engine and how it intensifies. Or like, you know, race cars and they rev and they start and it's that intensity. That's what it felt like. It felt like as my body was relaxing, there was this intensity that was building and it was an energy thing that was coming kind of upward, sort of. Or it was just like sort of concentrating. I don't know if it was actually moving upward, but it was kind of felt like it was in front of me. What ended up happening there was I ended up just like shifting over to the side. I ended up going through something and shifting over. And my sight, and again, this is like the way a person sees when they dream. It's very similar to that. You know, you see things in your dreams, you can recall dreams and things you saw, but your eyes were closed, your physical eyes were closed, but you could see things in your dreams. It's very similar to that. And I just like did some floating. My eyes weren't open. It was like kind of my eyes were like sort of open and closed like that. And I went through something and I was just kind of floating. So that energy that was building up as I was falling asleep, that revving, consciousness was attached to it. Consciousness was in that intensity of energy, and it floated off to the side, and my consciousness was floating off to the side along with that energy. So it's like an astral energy. And at the point at which I was floating, again, no detection of my body that's in my bed. I can't feel it breathing. I know that it's breathing. I know that it's fine. I know it's asleep. But my consciousness is elsewhere. I wanted to point that out. It's stuff that I guess is kind of there included in the videos when I talk about stuff like that. But I just wanted to like emphasize that consciousness I experience in those states of consciousness, but I'm not experiencing my physical body. When I'm separating and trying to go through the separation process, I can experience both. It feels like sometimes two different places at the same time and so on. But when there's an out-of-body experience, when I'm having like an OBE or an astral projection experience where I'm fully separated, it's a separation and my consciousness is separated. So I'm going about in this other astral body with my consciousness attached to that.